Hi and welcome! This short video is about the vertical barrel battery blaster, yet another drop-in replacement for leaky CMOS barrel batteries. It is a tiny PCB that uses a CR2032 battery holder of the vertical type. In a previous video, I had presented the original barrel battery blaster, which was a very similar board, but it used a battery holder of the horizontal type. This one is functionally identical, but it uses a vertical battery holder. In order to build one, you need the following. The PCB, which is so small that it is very affordable to get it fabricated. A vertical CR2032 battery holder. I am not sure what model this is, but these are widely available and quite affordable on Amazon and eBay. Next, we need a diode, preferably a Schottky, to avoid getting the CR2032 battery charged by the motherboard's charging circuit. The one I'm using in this video is a 1N5817, but any Schottky diode will do. Finally, we need two pins to attach the board to the motherboard. I'm using two pins out of a pin header, but a piece of thick copper wire will also do. Okay, let's build it. The battery holder is not perfectly straight, so let me straighten it by melting the solder. It's all good, now let's attach the pins. Please pay attention to the battery polarity on your motherboard. The positive pad should go to the positive pin of the PCB. Now let's solder the pins at the back of the motherboard. And we are done! The battery polarity is marked on the battery holder, so make sure you insert the battery the right way. And here is the final result. Okay, that's all for today. As with all my projects in this channel, this is open source and you can find all the files you need on the project's page on GitHub. After filming this video and while browsing theretroweb.com, I came across a very similar project by Wiretap Retro called Natavarta. The design is quite similar, but it uses a MAX40200 ideal diode, which may work better than the Schottky diode due to its zero voltage drop. The downside is that it consumes about 7 microamps, which is comparable to the consumption of the clock chip. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, thank you for watching and goodbye.